While commissioning Nyamuhuguza Bridge this afternoon, the Prime Minister Robin Anabanja noted that if the community joined hands with leaders and government, they could move mountains. According to Anabanja, the community needs to be mobilized and do a lot of things for the good of their areas.
Zengagala kuruite erinya lya muzeyi kubanga mutufu singati yapa kwa prime minister nezo sende sali zewoze nalisi ina kapasi
put over. I think I cannot tell you how much sand we put there because we are using basins, kavera, some pyro. Some people were bringing in black kavera. They would go there big and bring as we mix. We had put the mixers here. So I cannot tell you how many trips we got of sand, because everybody brought sand. It's there.
Allen Kajina, the executive director, Uganda National Roads Authority, hails the prime minister for the hard work to restore the bridge at Nyamuhuguza. Godfrey Chiwanda Subi, the NRM vice chairperson in charge of Buganda, challenged the people in the two districts to use the bridge to improve on household incomes.
Abaana bagenda kuyitako okusoma kitufu naye naawe tukubanja okuba ng'olina by'oyisaako.
Several leaders thanked the government for the quick response to the problem which had become a stumbling block to trade, health and education in the area. Pasco Mbabazi, the Buwekula North Constituency Member of Parliament, says that this is a clear testimony of community mobilization exhibited by the Prime Minister Robin Anabanja.
Chivdi, I want to thank the Prime Minister of Uganda, Right Honorable Anabanja Robina, who stood and looked around to mobilize the resources, not alone but also combining with other efforts from other leaders, like other members of Parliament from Mubende and Kakumiro. Now today, we've officially commissioned. What I can commend our people is to call upon them to utilize economically this bridge.
I come from CCCC. Our company, we are in Uganda more than 20 years. I'm very happy to can do this contribute to the community. You know, we do many roads constructing in Uganda, and we also very happy to have the chance to contribute to the community.
The residents in the two districts contributed local materials such as sand and stones and labor, while the government of Uganda, through the Ministry of Works, provided equipment, technical advice, culverts, and regular inspection and supervision of works. The bridge is estimated to cost over 450 million shillings and has restored hope among the residents. The Premier recognized some people who greatly contributed to the construction of the bridge and awarded them with certificates. In the months of October and November, the country experienced heavy rains that grossly affected the road network in most districts. Nyamuhuguza Bridge was washed away on November 4, 2023. Story compiled by Ismail Kasoha for the news.